It's end of March, and a lot of people are looking forward to planting clover in April, maybe May. And what I've personally experienced, and it's going back to mid-90s up into the early 2000s, that a lot of clover plots that are spring planted are destined for failure, and there are several reasons why. So we're going to go through the best way to plant clover, the best methods to plant clover, and I hope you'll agree with me. I planted clover over a 15-year period, many different ways, strategies that related to clover, and clover can be a very powerful planting in the right situation. I use it as a herd building planting in the UP of Michigan. Once the herd numbers were to the point where I wanted to maintain that number, then I stopped planting the clover. I actually reduced it down to just a fraction of what it was before, so that I still had that little bit of summer clover. But I found that even then I had to mow it two or three times because the deer just, they had too much forage, way several times more forage than needed in the local habitat. So the clover was really not necessary at that point. So clover sometimes is a fit, and that's an entirely different strategy altogether. But as far as planting goes, I want you to be successful with every planting, and clover is no exception. Even if it's not a great fit, I still want you to do a good job planting clover. First one, number one, people talk about frost seeding right now. Switchgrass needs to be frost seeded, at least the hard seed portion. When it states a germination rate, that's not including the hard seed. The germination rate is that soft seed that's available for germination within 2 weeks, as long as the soil temperature is good. And you've controlled weeds and everything else, gets sun to it. Clover is different. It does not need to go through that stratification process. It does not need frost seeding. So there's talk about frost seeding going back to the late 90s, mid 90s, and you don't need to frost seed clover. If you have a lot of rain in July, for example, you can throw it down in the soil, you get a good catch of clover. So it's going to germinate, it's going to come in, it's one of the easiest seeds that you could ever plant to germinate, even faster and easier than rye, which rye grows in the back of my pickup every year, but clover is even easier to germinate than rye, as long as you have the right correct soil pH and soil conditions for that planting. Frost seeding, a lost of people are doing that right now. A lot of people are frost seeding in areas where they haven't controlled weeds. So what happens is you frost seed in an area, whether it's a previously planted ag field, food plot, a weedy area, an area where you expose the soil, whatever reason or whatever type of conditions the soil are, you're getting that seed on the soil and you're frost seeding. And the bad thing is that you haven't controlled weeds. So what ends up happening, now you can spray chemicals, for example, clethodim is a grass-specific herbicide. They have a broadleaf 2,4-DB that you can spray and control broadleafs that won't kill the clover. Even glyphosate at 1 quart per acre, which you have to be very strict with before rain or a good growth period during the summer, can really wipe out a lot of your weeds, and then, of course, mowing. But the best thing to do with any food plot, switchgrass, whatever it might be, any time of planting, is to control weeds before they even crop up, because those weeds are going to limit growth, and that's just excess work and lower success rates down the road. The problem with frost seeding is that people, again, haven't maintained their weeds. They haven't controlled their weeds. And so you don't need to start that clover that early. That clover is going to begin germinating not that long after spring green up. And with that comes a big pile of weeds that you have to take care of. So what I encourage you to do is take care of your weeds first. You can wait till the green up takes place. Weeds are 6-8 inches high, 12 inches high, growing aggressively, good growing conditions. You can seed and then kill with 2 quarts per acre of glyphosate the exact same day. The glyphosate will not hurt the seed. It's a post-emergent. And unlike 2,4-D and then simazine, the glyphosate is neutralized when it touches soil. It doesn't actually stay in the ground and kill future broadleafs that are coming in. So you don't need to frost seed. You don't need to get a jump on it that early. By waiting just a little bit longer, you can take care of your weeds, at least get one good shot of 2 quarts per acre of glyphosate, and then seed the same time. And that way you set back your weeds, your clover has a lot greater chance of actually surviving going into the summertime. Now springtime, maybe, maybe not. And I'm just talking springtime in general. Again, you don't have to frost seed. You always want to wait, control your weeds. You just need lots of moisture, which you get plenty of moisture at the end of April, May, into early June. Problem with springtime is that weeds are thriving. Weeds are growing aggressively. Moisture is decreasing over time. So you get that clover established. My number one crop failure was a clover planting back in about 2001, 2002, where I had a great stand of clover. It was on a previously planted food plot, frost seeded. Clover grows into May, June, 5 inches, 6 inches high, very thick and lush. And then over a 9 week period, we had less than an inch of rain on light soils and the clover crop was completely dead. Springtime is not the best time to plant clover. So if we're just talking timing, the end of the summer going into early fall is always better. And the reason for that is number three, you can plant clover with a cool season annual. What that allows you to do is get the clover established, but then still have that hunting season oomph where you can actually have a very good hunting season draw. For example, the clover, I had great clover. I planted on a lot of my trails and pass through areas on my UP of Michigan property because I could count on the clover not being attractive in November because it was eaten down to the ground. We'd had lots of frost, freeze, snow, and it wouldn't grow. So every bite was not replaced and it was gone. And so that was a great place for me to access. You never want to plant your access trails. People say, well, let's plant this 2 or 3 miles of trails on the property and try to get some more food and it'll help the deer. Well, if you're inviting deer to your access, that is a very bad thing, folks. So clover sometimes, especially in northern areas, can be a great product for that because it can hold soil. And you're not going to have that attraction in October, November because it's cold. The clover hasn't been replaced. It's not really attracting much. And that's why it's great to plant with a cool season annual. I've planted clover with oats, rye, and brassica, going back all the way into the late 90s, before you could find anybody else doing that in the country, I believe. Anybody online, anything. I tested that. It worked really well. There's a lot of talk about frost seeding in the spring, and I thought, why would I get this area prepared and soil exposed in the fall to later frost seed in the spring and miss an opportunity to actually get a food plot on there during the fall, which could help me be a herd influencer and help me have a great hunt, build that herd. And so I didn't want to wait until that time, so I've always mixed. What that allows you to do is you focus on the timing of your fall annual, meaning cereal grains about a month after brassica, 5-6 weeks. Typically around these parts, you'd be Labor Day. I'm in southern Minnesota, southern Wisconsin, over into Michigan, UP of Michigan anyways, and southern Michigan, either one, over into Pennsylvania, New York. You're looking at a timing of early August for brassicas with clover or Labor Day weekend around there with clover and cereal grain blends. And so you don't want to ever plant them all together. You know, if you see a seed bag that has clover and cereal grains together, rye, oat, wheats, and brassica, that's a bad blend because they're both are going to fight with each other. The clover does not fight with any of it. The difference is with rye or wheat is in the spring, you have to mow it out or kill it with clethodim to get rid of that rye or wheat. You can't spray glyphosate on it because you're going to kill the clover if the wheat and rye is growing sufficiently during the warm-up to actually be able to kill it. So you'll kill your clover at the same time. And mowing works really well, so does clethodim. So you're looking at the cool season annual for that draw, and then you have the leftover carry and base of that clover blend going into the following year. So you have the cereal grains, rye, wheat, oats, brassica. They all make great nurse crops during the fall for that clover, and so does late planted peas or beans. We do that in a lot of soil builder blends where we're putting 10 pounds of medium red clover in the fall. Allows you to build that soil, and then you're planting into that clover. For example, brassica loves to follow clover. Corn loves to follow clover. So you can get that improvement of the soil built in with the clover during the fall, and then plant into it in the following spring, and that'll really help your soil put nitrogen back into the soil. So great time to plant with that cool season annual. And that's also at a time when weeds are dying, not thriving. And the cool thing is, unlike the spring where moisture is decreasing as the weeks progress, during the fall, moisture is increasing as time progresses. So when you get that established and you get it coming up, you're going to get moisture, whether it's August thunder showers, September rains, November, October, you get into some really heavy rain. Then you get another shot the following spring of moisture. And so I found that no matter what drought could throw my way the following summer, that clover would survive because it had its roots into the ground. So overall ability to not only get a successful stand of clover without weeds and to tap into the available moisture is at a premium in the fall, and so is, or late summer, and so is being able to plant that cool season annual that allows you to develop that clover base. Now, what I did in the UP, so I recognized early that those cool season annuals were what was driving my herd in the fall, the hunt, everything else. So I would actually plant that cool season annual with clover on one side. Let's say you start with a whole field, you do the whole thing in that cool season annual, the clover base. You allow half of that to grow for a year. The other half, you do the same thing the following year, whether you're combining that with clover, brassica, rye, wheat, oats. So you're taking out half that field, planting that cool season annual. You have the older clover that's a year old on this side, and then you just flip those every year. If you have a big enough plot, you can actually do it three. So you have a third, a third, a third. You have one that's two-year-old clover, one that's one-year-old clover, and then one that's new going into the fall. And that's how I built the herd in the UP in Michigan, by having that clover base. But again, once I, you know, we went from one spike and one scrape, one rub in 98, 99 to 17 different bucks in 2006, and about a stable base of 10 does and fawns somewhere around there. So we had, and of course those bucks weren't on the property all the time, but that's what we received on trail camera. I saw 11 from the stand, shot two of them. And that was a, if you look up four season food plots, you can find that. I first wrote that on Michigan Sportsman's site back in 2008. I believe it shows 2011 now, and then on my site I recopied that. And I also published that in the Quality Whitetails magazine for the QDMA with my findings when I was studying this and perfecting that method back in the 2000s. So great way. And I'll add one more thing, this last thing, do you have chicory? And the reason for that chicory is if you are planting in the spring, or you have extended periods of drought, even on a fall planting, then that chicory acts as a nurse crop and shades out your clover. And I've seen just a drastic difference between one half that has no chicory of a field in clover, and then the other half that has that combination. The combination side will be shaded. You'll have a lusher volume of clover, darker green, will be a lighter green in the sun exposed, non-shaded side. It only takes about a pound of chicory, and regardless of whether the deer like the chicory or not, it's a great nurse crop. What I find, it's there's always areas where a deer will eat chicory more than others, but what I found, even in the UP of Michigan, where they didn't have a lot of food, they ate it during the deer yarding time, where they are migrating through late November, December. That's when they'd end up hitting the chicory. It was usually the last thing standing in the plot, but it was still eaten during that hunting season. So it can act as a great nurse crop. So these are some great ways to plant clover. Ultimately, think late summer, think lime, food plot preparation, buckwheat rotations during the summertime, build your soil, and then introduce that clover with a fall annual around August 1st with brassica, beans, late planted beans and peas, and then going into September, early September with your cereal grains, rye, oats, wheat. And then the following spring, what's cool about the beans, peas, oats, and brassica is they're all dead and gone in the north half of the country. So you don't have that competition you have to deal with in the spring. You can actually seed at any time during the spring to fill in some holes and soft spots there of light clover. And then, of course, you can mow the rye or wheat out or kill it with clethodim, and you'll be left with pure clover. So those are some ways to not only experience a successful plot, but to make sure that you can safeguard with a nurse crop of chicory during the summertime during drought. And oh, by the way, to make sure that you have a great hunt in the fall, because what you'll find in the end is that although clover is great in the early season, great during the summer, especially if you're in herd building mode, it's not that great of a fall draw, because you can actually experience some of those doe factory problems with too many does during the summertime. Clover does really well in southern Ohio, Illinois, Indiana, Kentucky, West Virginia, portions where it stays warmer a little bit longer. You can get more life of it during the hunting season, but most of the areas in the north half of the country, you really want to put clover in, plant it with that cool season annual. And really, you can experience success whether it's a fit for your lane or not. I want you to have a great planting of clover, but always make sure that you're influencing your hunt and your herd, and that you're ultimately becoming a herd influencer with whatever activities and plantings that are taking place on your land this season. Hey guys, I really appreciate you watching today's video. We're out here having some fun today. We're planting some switchgrass, cutting some timber, making some bedding areas, but most importantly, we're putting it all together, and that's critical. Any habitat improvements you're making, you can't just make improvements because it's a good spot. You have to link those together so that helps your hunt this fall. Really, I encourage you to check out my web classes. The link is in the description. It's helped a lot of folks design their properties and do what we're out here having fun doing right now.